So my name is Nello D’Andrea. I will speak about Claude CLI. I'm a freshly minted MVP working for an insurance company, La Mobilière. And so this is Pantum. You want to tell me something? Oh, you want to be an MVP also? Okay. So it's an inclusive community and you have to show what you can, but maybe you will get also this recognition today. So. Okay, so I will speak a bit about Claude CLI, how it is built, and my favorite topics doing SPFx upgrades. And then Pantum will take the control and will do a cool demo about what he can do. Claude CLI was launched in May of this year, so it's quite a young product. About four months old. I use it since 3 months on a private project. What really cool is with Claude CLI is you can use it as CLI, but also it has an SDK, and I will show how I implemented, or Pantum has implemented something with the SDK. It uses three different models, Haiku. It's really a simple model just for text retrieval, Sonnet, which is a workhorse, and Opus for reasoning. So Sonnet was updated 2 days ago by Anthropic, and they said it can perform tasks for hours. So that's right, quite impressive. Subscription is really expensive. So max subscriptions between $100 and $200 per month. But it's much more economical than the API. I will also show how you can control your usage and how much token you use and so on. Basically, it performs operations. So it's doing file operation like reading, editing, executing command, and also doing search or even web search. Recommendation on my part is always initialize your instruction for the agent for a specific project. So you can do this with a slash init command and it will create a cloud MD command. And you should customize this instruction, read, and so on. Then it has three various modes. The first one is it's asking for every command it is executing. The second one is it's editing automatically, but will ask you if it's running a build or doing a git and so on. And the third one, which I use a lot, is plan mode. So you iterate and you ask Claude CLI to perform some analysis and then refine your plan until you can tell him, so it should then update the code. So it has five steps of reasoning. The first one is if you don't say anything, to use basic reasoning, so no thinking at all. It thinks, or it's an LLM, so it doesn't think like the people, but okay. And then you have four stage of thinking, which use tokens, a lot of token when you use, for example, UstraThink. So, and you can monitor your usage with tool called CCU usage. I will show that in the demo. Okay, now I switch here. I'll just show you. SPFx toolkit. There is an issue from Nello D’Andrea, and it says we want to change the site collection URL selection with a drop down list. Then I can switch to the project here. And I've prepared a prompt here. So this is the SPFx toolkit solution, which I forked from the original repo. I'm starting Claude. You can also have it as extension in Visual Studio Code and copying this. And then we will execute this. So I want to have an assessment about how to implement this issue. And the actual repo is a fork, and I've also linked the contributing guidelines. And starting this, and then you can see, for example, choreographing, that's Haiku, which is called, and here he's asking me to fetch the content from both this URL, which I've linked in the prompt, and now it's analyzing this. So this lasts a couple of minutes. It is now analyzing the markdown. It is also searching the solution. And as you can see here, I've already done an init. So this is a basic init. I didn't provide any additional instruction and so on. You can also see here it has some problem because some of the files are too big, but it search by itself alternative for this. Yeah. And here I will show how you can monitor your usage. So this is, I'm just showing here how you can do it live. So it's retrieving my token burn here. So the first one is session, my session, Claude code just split this in 5 hour session. So I have 3 hours remaining. And my burn rate is not so high because Pantom is going to take all the tokens after that. Okay. And I think, so it's already ready for the first iteration. I think this is just an example to show how this could be implemented. So it would be, it would need that I refine that and then do it. So, oh, Pantom, what's the problem? Okay. Ah, do you want me to show your tool or what you can? Okay. So I'm switching to my colleague Pantom. So Pantom is SPFx upgrade companion. It's AIM. So it has a terminal unit user interface. And it's now scanning my repo. Yes, I've started it just be very, very quiet. So I'm going here. I'm taking the first solution here, selecting this. I will explain that then in the and starting the demo. So that's great. So the flickering here, we did that in the. I will go back to the slides and maybe that's better. So let me juggle here. So. The various tools like Claude Code, OpenAI Codex, or the Google Gemini are all available as CLI. But Claude Code, as I've stated before, is also available as SDK and have also MCP support, full MTCP support. They all use their own LLM. And they are all built with a terminal UI framework, which is called Ink, and Pantom, which is our little colleague here also uses CLI and also has Claude Code integrated, so it uses the SDK to perform SPFx upgrade and is also using this Ink framework. So we have love doing SPFx upgrades until we don't. So in my company, we have about 100 SPFx solution, which we regularly upgrade. So once a year, SPFx is great. It's dynamic. And so there is always new SPFx version. There is some preparation, then it's binding quite a lot of resource. And I started thinking about automating this. And I started with the great 365 CLI, so it generates a SPFx upgrade report. Then I've done implemented the patching, and then came we leveraged this great component PNPGS upgrades, also integrated. Then I stumbled upon MGT deprecation, and also I've done some dependency implementation, so general non-Microsoft or non-SPFx specific upgrades. And at the beginning of September also came this Shaila Ulu warrant, and I thought, why not just scan the software after you have upgraded it. I'd also built a little complexity analyzer which gives some support to understand how the solution is is built. So just switch back to Bantu, which is still flickering. That's okay. So yeah. Okay. I've upgraded the solution before. So it's 1.11 upgrade. It's the avatar solution, which I've created an hour ago. So we can have a look how Pantum did that. So it generates a lot of JSON report and so on to track that. And it also generate an MD file. And I will just show that here. And it shows us a lot of every patch which it has us applied. And then you can also see at the end, just coming here, sorry, I'm switching a lot, very fast. So it has upgraded here. And then you see, so the upgrade of a solution from 1.11 to 1.21.1. It cost $1.38. So in token, I have the a subscription, so it costs nothing. But if you would do it with an API, then this would be the cost for the upgrade. So, and I can also just show the solution here. So I'm just coming here, same. So I'll do a GURP serve, no browser. So great. And if I come here, and yeah, I have to pick the URL here. So it's already here, and I can. It's a great solution. So I can choose some accessoire or change the hair color and just put some great haze. So it's upgraded. So let's see if it did upgrade the other one here. Sorry for that. Yeah, it's also ready with the next upgrade. So within 5 or 10 minutes, you can put this great. So, yeah, I'm switching back. Great. Now, yeah, Pantum want to have some feedback from you. So, are you upgrading? Yes, no, why? Do you have any pain point? And would you let the tool automate your upgrade and so on? So, because Pantum doesn't have an email or a phone, you can contact me and then I will forward this to him. Okay. And I also sharing some resources about Cloud Code, also the Visual Studio extension of Cloud Code, which is basically the same as the CLI. And then the SDK, if you want to implement it in your solution, like it is implemented in Pantum. Also the terminal UI, which is what Cloud Code use or Codex, and how you can implement your or you can monitor your usage. Great.